Get ready for a perfect day at Coco Cay. From exhilarating water slides that will make your heart race, to exploring captivating plane wreck sites while snorkeling, and the sheer delight of unwinding on pristine beaches, our last day of the Caribbean cruise was truly unforgettable. Join me as I will show you around and share our remarkable experience at Coco Cay, coming up next. Hi fellow travelers, this is Ken and welcome to my channel, Ken Travels 360. Today is day 7 of the Caribbean cruise on Symphony of the Seas. And today, we're at Coco Cay. Coco Cay is used by Royal Caribbean exclusively to deliver a pirate island experience called Perfect Day at Coco Cay. After the renovation in 2019, there's just so much to do here. Free activities include multiple beaches with snorkeling possible and freshwater pool and various dining options. This year, they will be adding a new adults-only area at Highway Beach. It's still being constructed, but hopefully when we come back next year with their brand new icon of the seas, we'll get to experience it. There is no cost to get off the cruise ship to enjoy the private island. You're free to walk around, enjoy the beaches, and the swimming pools and food is always included as well. And if you have any drinks package purchased for your cruise, they are valid at Coco Cay as well, unlike at any other normal ports. Similarly, if you have bought an internet package, yep, it works fine at Coco Cay too. One of the biggest appeals of this private island is that a lot of activities are centrally located within a short walk from the pier. Here, you've got beaches, water park, food and drinks, snorkeling, zip lining, and hot air balloon, etc., all gathered in one place, which will hopefully make for a perfect day. So, we're ready to leave now. For Coco Cay, we just need to bring the following: sea pass card, our snorkeling kit, beach towels from the ship, water shoes, and our camera and my phone. Okay, we're ready to get out now. We are at Coco Cay. So first, we'll go to the free water park. By the way, the water park does cost money to get in, but we have $100 on board credit, and combined it with a Black Friday sale, we managed to get in quite cheaply. Right, so we're walking up the Daredevil Peak now, the tallest slide in Coco Cay. From here, you can get a really good view of Symphonies of the Seas. While we were queuing, we could see one of the two drop slides of Duelling Demons. Just looking at it was terrifying. You could see people praying when they go in. I think I will leave this till much later. By this point, I've waited around 40 minutes, and now looking back down, I could see the line has got really long. So if you have bought the free water park admission, my suggestion is to get into the water park as early as possible and join the line for this one first. Today, the condition is really windy, and as a result, the hot air balloon is not flying today. From up here, you do get a great view of the whole water park.
This is so far high up, about 10 stories or something like that. And I counted the time people get down to the bottom. It was about 17, 18 seconds. So it's going to be a really fast ride.
Wow, this lady doesn't hesitate going in. Finally, it's my turn. Okay, here I go.
Wow, that was awesome. Whoa!
That Daredevil's Peak was awesome, really awesome. It's not as scary as it looks, even though it's so high up.
Next, we'll be trying one of the slides in the Splash Summit. This one, right in front of me, is called Splash Speedway, where four riders race each other down the slides. Next to it, you have the slingshot, and very soon, we'll see what happens at the end of the ride. We're gonna try Twister though, where two people slide down a winding tube on a tandem raft. We went back to the Daredevil's Towers to try a few of the less scary slides. However, they were all very slow. So eventually, I decided it's time to try the Duelling Demons. For this one, I left my GoPro camera with Steve at the bottom.
So I just tried the Duelling Demons one, where you basically get into a box and then the floor opens below you, and then you get into a rather steep drop followed by a long slide around. It was very exhilarating.
After that scary ride, we decided to go to the wave pool. They describe it as brave, the largest wave pool in the Caribbean. I have to say, it wasn't very exciting. The queues for the slides are now really long. So we decided to go to the adventure pool to have some fun.
Right, we just had a good morning of slides and all this thrill. It's now time to have some lunch. So just like on the ship, the food is included in Snack Shack. We're gonna get some food there. So we just ordered some food, and it's a burger. Nothing very fancy. Some fries. They have some dessert behind me and fruits, so we'll have that later. If you enjoyed watching this video, please give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel with notification enabled. That way you'll be notified whenever I release a new video. So we're now heading to Chill Island, where we can snorkel. So we're entering Chill Island. Chill Island is a great place to be if you like your beach quiet. Keep to the left and you will find an area with magnificent ocean views with no music or noise, and just the sound of ocean waves. Here, you can enjoy great snorkeling too. We brought our own snorkel gear, as I don't like to use shared snorkel masks. Alternatively, if you have forgotten yours, you can rent your equipment on the island too. There's even a lifeguard on a platform near the deeper end of the snorkeling area, and you'll see plenty of marine life, including fish, stingrays, and perhaps even a sea turtle. There is a crane wreck underwater which attracts marine animals too. Okay, I just got a new mask before this trip and I'm gonna try it out. We're now snorkeling at Chill Island. We'll see whether we can get to the shipwreck.
The plane wreck site is said to be relatively easy to locate, with a lifeguard station and a platform nearby. However, due to strong winds and choppy waters on that particular day, visibility in the sea was limited. It wasn't until I got closer to the wreck that it became visible. I was so happy to have snorkeled the plane wreck site. I was quite exhausted by then, so I started to swim back, and that's when I noticed a stingray swimming by. After the snorkeling, we decided to move to the South Beach area. As we walk over there, I'll introduce other areas that we'll see too.
In front of us, this is the Harbour Beach. Behind me, this is the Oasis Lagoon. This is probably the place that most people head to. It's a big freshwater swimming pool with a swimmer bar. You can see it's very noisy and very crowded. Right now, I'm at South Beach. South Beach is another great area that is not so crowded as it's furthest away from the pier. Behind me, you can see the Coco Beach Club. This one, you have to pay extra, and it's very nice there. You get attendant service and your private cabana, and even overwater bungalows. If you do book one of these, try to be here early to maximize your time to use these facilities. It's worth mentioning that Coco Beach Club has its own restaurant, and there you have very luxurious food items like lobster, steak, grilled fish, etc. While you're at South Beach, don't miss the floating bar. They have a more limited selection of drinks as they don't have blenders there, but the experience here is worth it. By the way, it's worth mentioning that all the chairs and umbrellas on the islands are free to use.
It's now getting a bit cloudy as well as a bit late in the day, so we're gonna go back to the ship. You could take the tram, or in my case, I'll walk around to try to check out as much as I could. Although I suspect most of the facilities are closing or closed.
Behind me, this is Chill Grill. Chill Grill is like Windjammer of the island with a great variety of food to choose from. Chill Grill is also where to go to get your soft serve ice cream. Over there, you can see Skipper's Grill. Skipper's Grill is centrally located and is very similar to Chill Grill.
Here, you can find Captain Jack's, and it's one of the food options on the island that has an extra charge. They offer chicken wings, fries, and drinks, and have live music with water views.
There are some free slides outside the free water park, but they are for kids really. Captain Jill's Galleon behind me and Splash Away Bay are the two water splash areas that are near the pier. They are provided by Royal Caribbean for free. Right, we all had a great stay at Coco Cay, and it's now time to return to the ship, Symphony of the Seas. So this is tonight's menu for Voyage. I think I'm gonna start with the pan-seared asparagus, and I'm gonna have both lamb and steak. And I think I will have the dark chocolate brownie tonight. Wow, our main course dinner has arrived. Main course number one is the lamb shank. Looks really good indeed. For my dessert, I have chocolate brownie, whereas Steve's is called creme catalana. So this is the only bar I haven't tried yet, Copper and Kettle. We're gonna try it now because we have the drinks package. So we looked through the menu and we decided to try this Boston iced tea party.
Tastes a lot like Long Island iced tea, but maybe a bit sweeter. Lots of alcohol in it.
Finally, I'm gonna show you the final show of the cruise, iSkates 2.0. This is my second favorite show after Hero, which you can watch in episode 1. I recorded a lot of footage, so this is just the highlights version. I may edit a video just to show the extended highlights of the show if there is demand. Let me know in the comments.
Share that applause with our technical team that make this ice arena come alive.